गोपाल, माधव, केशव, रणछोड़दास, मुरली मनोहर, मनमोहना एंड वासुदेव. ही इज अ मैन नोन बाय मेनी नेम्स अक्रॉस द इंडियन सबकॉन्टिनेंट. ही इज पॉपुलरली नोन एज कृष्ण. बट डिड ही रियली एग्जिस्ट? इन द नेक्स्ट फ्यू मिनट्स वी आर गोइंग टू एक्सप्लोर सर्टन फैक्ट्स बिहाइंड द लेजेंड ऑफ कृष्ण. श्रीमद भागवतम डिक्लेयर्स दैट कृष्ण अराइव्स ऑन अर्थ टुवर्ड्स द एंड ऑफ द्वापर युग of the 7th manvantar of the first kalpa of the 51st year of the current brahma. To know more about this, see our video on Hindu Kala Chakra. According to astronomical calculations of Aryabhata, Kaliyuga began in 3102 BCE. Now this would place Krishna roughly around 3300 to 3200 BCE, as the Bhagavatam states that Kaliyuga couldn't begin till Krishna was on the planet.
References to Krishna can be found in almost all major scriptures, and there are profuse references to the famous personalities of that age in Vedic, Jain and Buddhist literature. The earliest authentically datable reference to Krishna is from the Chandogya Upanishad. Composed around 900 BCE, it mentions Vasudev Krishna as the son of Vasudev and Devaki and the disciple of Ghorangirasa. Jain tradition from around 700 BCE talks about Vasudev and his elder brother Baladev in each cycle time. They take birth to rid the world of evil and kill the Prati Vasudev. Additionally, Krishna is also described as the cousin of the 22nd Tirthankar Neminath, whose historicity is believed by most Jains today. Panini, the ancient grammarian and author of Ashtadhyayi, in 6th century BCE, mentions Vasudev, Kauravs and Pandavs and testifies to them being contemporaries of each other.
Buddhist literature records Krishna the earliest in the Ghata Jataka, which is around 300 BCE, as an ancient ruler of India, and gives an account of his exploits that corresponds quite well with the Hindu tradition. There is a good record of the presence of Vasudev and Baladev, killing of Kamsa and their cousins, the Kurus. The Mahaumagha Jataka around 3rd century BCE states that Jambavati was one of the consorts of Vasudev or Kana, which matches with the description from the Bhagavatam. Around 150 BCE, Patanjali in his Mahabhashya praises Krishna and Sankarsana and describes dramatic performances representing the killing of Kamsa by Vasudev.
Surprisingly, we even have evidence provided by foreign travelers, such as the Greek scholars who came to India during and after Alexander's campaign. Megasthenes, from 350 BCE, the Greek ambassador to Chandragupta Maurya, the first unifier of medieval India, identifies Krishna with the Greek Heracles or Hercules in his famous work Indica. He describes an Indian tribe called Saurasanoi, who worshipped Heracles in their land, which had two cities, Methora and Plaisobora, and a navigable river, the Jubaris.
The reasons for this mistaken identification are quite understandable. First, the Greek historians tried to make sense of other religions' gods by equating them with their own divinities. And secondly, the 12 labors of Hercules have a lot of similarities with the acts Krishna performed as a kid. For example, Krishna subdues the monstrous serpent Kaliya, whose very breath could kill someone with its poison, while Hercules kills the equally monstrous Hydra and also beheads the snake-headed Medusa, whose single look could turn anyone into stone. From descriptions given in the Indica, there is little doubt that the Saurasenoi refers to Krishna's dynasty, the Shurasena Yadava. Methora to Mathura, and Klaisobora to Krishnapura, and finally Jubaris to the Yamuna, the river from Krishna's life story. Quintus Curtius also mentions that when Alexander confronted Porus or Puru on the banks of the Indus River, Porus's soldiers were carrying an image of Heracles in their vanguard. The court scholar of Mauryas states that the city Polybrotha, that is Patliputra or Patna, was founded by Heracles about 138 generations before the reign of King Sandrokotas, which is the Greek name for Chandragupta Maurya.
A statite tablet which was unearthed from Mohenjo-daro in 1931 depicts a young boy uprooting two trees from which are emerging two human figures. It has been considered an interesting archaeological finding for fixing the date of Krishna. Dr. E.J.H. Mackey, who did the excavation at Mohenjo-daro, compares this image with the Yamalarjuna episode, and Professor V.S. Agarwal has also accepted this identification. In this image, the young boy depicted could very well be Krishna, and the two beings emerging out of the trees could be the two cursed Gandharvas, Nalkubera and Manigreva, who had turned into Arjuna trees due to a curse and were liberated by Krishna. Interestingly, scriptures talk about a kind of a passport system in Dwarka. Its citizens were issued a clay seal with a mythical three-headed animal. Could it be the Greek Cerberus, which had to be presented when they entered or left the massive gates? Interestingly, this seal of Dwarka has been found in the underwater ruins of the city.
An 800 BCE cave painting in Mirzapur, Uttar Pradesh shows a horse charioteer about to hurl a wheel on another figure. This episode can potentially be identified as Krishna getting ready to hurl the chariot wheel on Bhishma Pitamaha from the Mahabharata war. Heliodorus was a Greek ambassador who was sent from Taxila to the court of King Bhagabhadra at Videsh. Interestingly, this guy has left the first historical record of a Greek becoming the devotee of an Indian god, that is Shri Krishna. On his visit to Videsha, Heliodorus erected a Garuda pillar in the honor of his god of gods, that is Krishna, which is one of the earliest direct archaeological evidence of Krishna consciousness in this part of the world. Another discovery of the Indo-Greek period is the gold coins of Agathocles in 200 BCE, bearing the images of Balram holding his plow on one side and Vasudeva Krishna holding the discus, which is Sudarshan Chakra, on the other side. The evidence for Krishna Balram worship can also be found from the stone graffiti of Chilas Cave in western Pakistan. Here, Krishna and Balram are engraved on the rocks, and the names engraved beneath the images are Vasudev and Sankarshana respectively.
An inscription from a Mora well 11 kilometers west of Mathura records the construction of a stone temple by a royal woman named Tosho in honor of Bhagavatam Panchaviranam, or five heroes of the Vrishini clan. Mauves, an Indo-Scythian king in 85 BCE, was a worshipper of Balaram along with Greek gods Zeus and Nike. Few of his coins depict a king in a cross-legged seated position, and one of his coins minted in the 1st century BCE depicts Balaram. Last, but certainly not the least, the eyehole inscription of King Pulakeshin II, dated 634 CE, states the Mahabharata war was fought 3735 years before the engraving of the inscription, which gives the date of 3735 minus 634, which equals to 3101 BCE. We may not have the exact date for Krishna's appearance on earth, but these shreds of evidence narrow it down to at least a tangible time frame in our history. Through the analysis of all the above data shared with you, the most probable period of Krishna's stay on earth would be 3300 to 3100 BCE.
In the end, even if we assume that he was mythical, his character still teaches us about protecting nature through his story of Govardhan. Today, neither atheists nor theists tend to study these epics beforehand. We all believe what others tell us to believe. We must remember that atheism without investigation is ignorance, and faith without rectification is folly. Even though Krishna was present in the war, Abhimanyu and Ghatotkach died a brutal death. This teaches us that no god is ever going to interfere in our lives. We are the creator of our own lives. The words of Krishna can be guidelines, but the actions and choices will always be yours. We can choose to be good.
Even in Gita, Karma Yoga comes before Bhakti Yoga. So let's emulate Krishna for his ideals rather than praying to his idols. Let us try to inculcate and implement Gita as a philosophy of human life rather than worshipping it as a holy book. So stay tuned, stay educated, and last but not the least, know your culture by self-investigating the truth. Shubhaste Panthanaha Santu, Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.